architecture of Kiri Patana Grahis. Your same
part.
Hi, my name's the Reverend Chris Howitz, and I'm the Anglican chaplain in Oman, and welcome. Hundreds of thousands, because there are lots of Catholic, Roman Catholic Christians from the Philippines, from India, and then there are lots of Protestant and Orthodox Christians, especially from the Indian subcontinent, so we have huge numbers that we oversee. Our church looks after 60 congregations. Some of them are very big, about 700 people. Some of them are just small, 50 people. And we have our own congregations. We have four congregations, one of 500, one of 50. And we found people are very friendly in Oman to Christians. They're very interested. So I had lots of really good conversations with Omanis asking about my faith and about what Christians believe, and they're very friendly and welcoming people. Some people, their interest goes so far, and then once they have had their questions answered, they're not interested anymore, but they're very friendly and welcoming, and I've never had any issues at all, yeah. I mean, I think the interest comes in two levels. One is people want to assure me that they are welcoming and we can be friends, and I make the point that we don't believe the same things, but we can still be friends, and this is important, I think, even when there are disagreements. I think the second thing is that people have questions about do we believe in three gods as Christians, and I say no, believe in one God, and try and explain something of how we understand. We believe in one God, but we believe that the Trinity is one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So this is a very complicated issue, but we believe that comes out of Jesus's death and resurrection, and that then makes us look back and try and understand. So people ask questions like this, or they ask questions, say, how can God allow Jesus to die? How can you suggest that Jesus, a good person, would die on the cross? This is a horrendous thing. And so I have to speak about that he was tried for blasphemy, and they thought he was blaspheming. And so, but from my perspective, that Jesus taking death for us is an important understanding, that he died on our behalf. So lots of questions like this. I think this is the difference, is that people are not afraid to have strong opinions, but we leave as friends. So we have discussions about, obviously, my Muslim friends, my Omani friends, some of them want me to become a Muslim because they think he's a nice man. We don't want him to, you know, they think if I'm not a Muslim, I will be in problems in the afterlife. And so they're wanting to vigorously defend their faith and to challenge me, but also encourage me to think. My hope is for people to consider Jesus. You know, that's not my role to convert anybody. God only can do this. But I'd love for everyone to, you know, I think Jesus is God come to rescue us. So I want everyone to know this. I'm not going to go and force people this, but if they want to discuss that, my hope is that they can see something of my position, maybe. So, yeah. Yeah, I want to challenge those stereotypes. I think obviously Britain and France have many Muslims in their midst, and I want to encourage people to have a dialogue and discussion and be friendly and relate to people and not see people as an enemy or somebody to push away, but to relate to. And I think I don't think Christians should be afraid of Muslims. They should be confident of their faith, and they should be welcoming and loving. So I'm always trying to encourage Christians, people I meet, to reach out, to have those conversations, and to also think how they can explain their faith, but also how they can listen to what Muslims believe. A lot of Christians have love in their heart for you, and they don't see you as the enemy. And I'm very sad when I look at Europe and see the divisions that are happening because people are afraid. And I'm very sad, because my feeling is that Christians should be not afraid. They should be happy to reach out with love to their neighbours. And my hope is that will happen as it happens here in a small way, also happen in many countries, in France, in England, and there will be less divisions and more care for each other and love for each other.